Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Kūpuna Network. And you know, if you're having at all a hard time to understand, it's because, you know, the mask. The mask, that's where you folks go. Hey, Brick, what did you say?
Well, I don't know. How you know it's me?
I don't know, looking kind of fierce, my brother.
Well, these are necessary.
Yeah.
These are a
necessity.
Wash your hands.
Yeah.
Wear your mask.
Yeah.
Socially distant.
Look at this, bro. Look at this. You know why? Because then it's always there, right? So when they say, hey, what happened to your mask? You can just put them back on. Instead of going, wait, it's in my pocket or it's someplace. I can't tell you how many people go one place, they're sitting down eating, and they have to go back to the buffet, and they're looking for the mask.
It's been quite a skill set, though, developing a skill by which to recognize somebody with a mask on.
Well, I don't know. You've always been powerful when it comes to Kūpuna, my brother.
Well, you know? Kūpuna being one of the...
With the mask or without the mask, you have been on it.
This is
so
the reason,
I just like to say that.
That's the reason why we've decided to come and join you today. Yeah. To talk some story about, you know, Kūpuna. We're very, very pleased and honored to be here as part of the Kūpuna Network.
Yeah, to be Kūpuna, you know, because when you Kūpuna... I don't remember after that.
So what is Kūpuna?
Kūpuna, right?
Yeah.
Our treasured elders. Right. So go ahead.
So okay.
No, because I know you have something more to add.
Well, because we got the Kūpuna Power Show going on right now, right? With the two seasons. There's a lot that we've been able to learn and be able to surmise and be able to... Look, I just made 65.
Wow.
I'm the best example of Kūpuna Power programming because I get to follow my own show. Like Medicare, Medicaid, open enrollment, everything like that. But here's what the deal.
Hey, wait. Wait till you get to 72. That's all I have to say. Wait till you get to 72, brother, when all the eggs are coming about. And when you go to golf course, you're going, oh yeah, my hip was sore and my leg went, I don't know what happened.
The game's shorter. The game's a lot shorter now, huh?
Oh, did you have to say that?
Yeah, but main thing is you're shooting your age.
Oh, yeah, I'm shooting it. And then I have to quit.
You know, we were in radio for a long time. Well, hopefully some of you guys remember that. And one of our good friends was Mo Kiali.
Oh.
And Mo was a great performer. He was a good brother. And he was a good golfer.
Adam.
Since we're talking about Mo.
Yeah.
But Mo used to walk up to the tee.
Yeah.
And then he'd tell us, okay, what's the score for this hole? We didn't even hit the ball yet.
What?
That's how we played.
Yeah.
He always came under par.
And what a great actor.
Yeah.
Great musician.
Yeah.
And just kind of heartfelt, yeah? During his younger days at Queen Surf, he was known as Animal because he was big, strong, and did his job. But ultimately, Mo was unlike any other.
Yeah, Sons of Hawaii. So that's why we're here today, okay? This is good because I think we're getting a snapshot of what we can talk about. We'll be talking about friends, we'll be talking about lives, we'll be talking about you. We'll be talking about how we can make our way through this golden years, right? Mm-hmm. So here's what we say in the Kūpuna Power Show. So Kū means to stand.
Right.
Puna for the punavai or the spring water. So there's all of this knowledge, there's all of that, and to stand firm your life. So the Kūpuna. So Kūpuna, as far as we, you know, define it, is a state of mind, right? It's like empowering yourself with, you know, your golden years. Share your golden years, make it golden for those around you too.
Yeah, well, you know, what's beautiful is to be able to do that, to be able to actually not feel like you're old. Yeah. I mean, I'm 72, but I have wonderful moments where I'm looking at the world. I don't have to look at me. So I can say, hey, this is what I'm gonna do. This is what's important for me. You know, oh, why drive to the golf course when I can walk to the golf course and it's like walking 9 holes. And I get there and I go, okay, I'm warmed up. I'm pretty much ready to go. So keeping our bodies in shape with our minds and our spirit and what we wanna do is all important. But you can do that at home.
Yeah.
You don't need to go any place.
You get the physical, you get the mental, you got the spiritual.
Yeah.
Right? And they all kind of get combined over time so that they become, you know, one and the same. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's a great time in our lives, right? And just, I would assume everybody watching, you're in this space if you are Kūpuna. How do you define to Kūpuna, right?
You cannot see your license.
Yeah, right. You cannot get there until you get there.
Yeah.
Because the 30-year-olds, the 40-year-olds, the millennials, okay, the Gen X's, or you know what the heck the label is, you know. No. But once you hit, say, 50, AARP senior discounts.
Right.
They got you on the database now, right?
Yeah.
And then 55, you start maybe being able to walk around the stores and get some discounts and stuff like that. You're coming into the 60s, now you're preparing for the Social Security, the Medicare, Medicaid. That in and of itself is a bear.
Yeah.
So for those
and
of you—
And you know, when they close the office,
yeah.
Oh, it's really thrilling and exciting for Kūpuna, right? Because it's closed. Unemployment, closed. Social Security, closed. Federal, when you want to talk about Medicare, it's not just Medicare A, it's Medicare B, C, D, whatever it is. It's important. How do you get to it? Especially with times of COVID-19, having a hard time, yeah? I don't blame you. We all are. Patience is so important. And do not put it on yourself. Don't put it on yourself. It's not you. It's what's happening outside of you. You are very special, right?
Absolutely. I think everybody watching this program and who have been watching the vast, majority of programs that Kūpuna Network has put out is learning every time you watch the show, whatever show you're watching. I understand, you know, there's been like Sean Pimentel. I heard he's playing music for the audience over here. A lot of guys coming in, giving good information and right. and things like that. What we want to do today is just talk story. We just want to talk story. We want to talk story with you. We want to talk story with each other because we used to be on the radio, I don't know how many years, almost a decade together, yeah, Kimo?
Yeah, and you know, being on radio and being together, we were at a special time in our lives, okay? Now, jump forward. We are at another time. We have great wisdom.
Oh, we like to think so, I mean.
Wisdom.
Yeah, really.
That's right. Whiz, that's the time that goes past. Dumb.
You decide.
Sometimes you feel dumb.
You decide what that means.
But okay. But really, in the humor of it all, it's about caring about each other now. Not talking about how Kūpuna are old and this and that, but how much wisdom we have, how much the ability we have to share with the grandchildren.
Yeah, yeah? Kūpuna, sure. The Mōpuna. And you know what? They got so much to share with us. I mean, it's like, take example of this, all right?
Okay.
Okay, this is instant gratification. It also could be instant devastation. Because whenever I got to look something up, and boom, I got to call my 13-year-old granddaughter.
Uh-huh.
You can hear her eyes rolling, right? But that's okay, because she's helping Papa.
Yeah, and it's high tech, right? So we didn't have high tech. We had tech, we had a lot of stuff, we had computers, we thought we had everything. And now it's moved to another level. So does it eliminate who we are and what we do? Evidently not. Why? Because we eventually have to get into it. Otherwise, how can you Zoom with the whole family? Especially if half the family is on the East Coast, or the West Coast, or even in other parts of the world, Japan, Europe. Right? So you gotta get it together, find the simplicity and make it work. And guess what? You can. Never say you can't. You just gotta find that genius grandson or granddaughter who's gonna help Papa and Mama.
Really, man? So how many grandkids you got now? How many grandchildren you got now?
Grandchildren, I get 9 boys and 2 girls. You get 11 all together.
11.
Yeah.
Okay, I got 7 boys and 2 girls. And if your girls are like my girls, they talk those guys silly. They just kind of like, the boys are just kind of got this glazed look over their eyes, right? And the girls just kind of, the girls are the alphas in my clan. Yeah. But.
Well, mine, the boys are so big. you know, they're so strong, they're doing stuff. Well, Haku was a, you know, defensive end. Then he goes to war as a major. Then he comes back and he's a doctor. And he's doing stuff on the East Coast and he's near his sons. And I told him, I said, son, you know what the most important thing, contribution you make right now? Be with your boys. Nobody has a doctor, a master's degree, and a fine arts degree together in one person, and that's you, Dad.
Yeah.
And talk about martial arts, bro. He's still tough.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
I recall when we were doing early morning, and you were really proud of Haku.
Yeah.
I think it was going...
Go Bulls.
Yeah, Go Bulls. It was Go Bulls time. And then... Kamuela,
the musician. We got to perform on Hawaii Stars Christmas show. For the first time, we got to be together and share it. And you know what I loved about it? Is that we were just doing our own thing and just having fun and sharing in the tempo. It wasn't like critical and anything else but that. It was wonderful, positive stuff.
Yeah, good.
It's good. And then Ikaika is the guy behind the scenes. He's like, okay, you take five computers, put them all together, that's Ikaika.
So three boys and you got 11 grandchildren.
And 11, two girls and nine boys. And Leilani has, of course, two daughters.
Oh,
so we kind of, what do you call that family?
Extended or blended.
Yeah, there you go.
You got all these labels, right?
You get all the labels, you go in. But the main thing is the two beautiful ladies, one's on the North Shore surfing, bro, winter surf. And the other one's in Seattle, and you know, that's life, right? But you mentioned being blessed and that spirit. And I think that, Bob, that was well said. You know why? Because that's what we need. When everything else is just terrible, and no matter what, we can always turn to the blessing of our Father, right? The blessings of God. The blessings, and it doesn't cost you anything. It's just there.
Yeah.
And what happens? We are forgiven. We are sharing. We are positive. We are loved. Oh. Ah,
you know,
the best.
I gotta say, and this is for the viewers as well, that
yeah.
I hope you can feel the aloha we got for each other. Because we rarely get together. So today's a very, very special time for us. And when we learned that we would have a chance to be with you folks, to share our lives
yeah.
with each other too, and you'd be on the table. Well, I hope that you know it's fulfilling for you as much as it is for us.
So you guys, I know it's nap time, but come on, just wake up a little more. I promise you, we're gonna be pound before you know it. Okay?
Hey, okay. So for a quick one, maybe at least for about 5 minutes. How much time we got left? Maybe a few more minutes or whatever. We'll talk about Kūpuna Power, okay? If
yeah.
you don't mind, because this is the new brand that's coming up.
Go, baby.
Right? Well, you were the first guest on the first show.
Thank you.
That's right, absolutely.
Thank you.
And we talked about Kimo's life, and not many people knew that Kimo was the guy who used to stand in front of the wax museum in Waikiki with his malo on and his cape and his mahi ole. And then, like you said, everything was up there and everything went downhill from there.
Well. You start at the top. So I started at the Kahala Hilton with Danny Kalikini.
Yeah.
So here I am, not even imagining how wonderful this place is. And Penny Silver Wells is the beautiful vocalist. And Kaipo Prajean is there. And Lena Alaturia, former Miss Hawaii. And Darlene Hutchinson, my cousin. And the band is Jimmy Kaupuiki. And all the boys are just playing. Donald Meinel, who ends up going to Disney World and becoming a special guy. So, bro, I did start at the top, but what I meant was over there.
Do it.
Show. And then I said, you know, I got to go learn stuff by myself. So when I left the show, I went to the Royal Hawaiian Hotel, and that was it. You got to just keep going. You got to learn for you. Otherwise, you know, it's okay. You're part of it. But you've got to learn, right? And you know that. All of you Kūpuna know what you did to change your life. Sometimes you had to step back, right? We had to step back. Something bad happened. We had to leave a job. And we're going, oh man, how are we gonna make it? But we found a way. We found a way. And just like us, both of us, we found a way.
Found a way. You know, you started at the Kahala, I started at the Royal Hawaiian. Yeah. I started with Goofy, Marlene Tsai.
Goofy, yeah.
Yeah, so she was the first stop along the way, and then, you know, from there, we went on and on and on. And then I was telling Bumatai, we were on stage, right? And Bumatai and Kimo McVeigh in the audience.
And yeah, I wonder why.
Yeah, I wonder why. So we're looking at them. They weren't watching the show. They were looking at the proscenium.
Right.
They were looking at the lights, the camera, the action. Because about 3 months later, they were in the room and we were out. But that's the way it goes, right? Showbiz.
Kimo Wilder McVeigh. Yeah, what okay. can you say, brother?
Yeah, there you go. Those are some names. And they're, you know, for, I know that the viewing audience knows these people. I know that they live some of this with us. And so.
Hey, look at Andy. I mean, here's a guy who's been a comedian, and nobody besides like Sterling Mossman and going back in the day were given that kind of tribute, right? So here's Andy Bumatai. He's going to come out and he's going to be a comedian at the most formal showroom in Waikiki. It's a miracle.
Yeah, that was a mind blower.
But it happened.
And of course, there are days with Don Ho and, you know, with Al Harrington, like you. Right. And then, of course, Danny Kalaikini, Mr. Toe-Ta-Toe, right?
Right. Yeah. 30 years at the Kahala.
So he was on the show, on the Kūpuna Power show, okay? Yeah. And I said, Danny, aloha and welcome to Kūpuna Power.
Aloha, Kaneohia. Welcome. What is this? A dead palm tree. Feel the makane, the wind blowing through the leaves.
And then he goes into the doxology. I'm just sitting there. And even before we get into the show, he's blessed the show. He's getting his first lines in. And then we go into the show. And it was just an incredible.
Yeah. Remember the nose flute?
The nose flute.
Yeah. And you know, the big thing I learned from Kanaela, Rick, was that he never gave you less.
Oh, yeah.
Never. Always dressed, always sharp, always smiling. Every part of that show, he always gave his audience. And that, perhaps that's why he was successful.
Well, we've been here for, I don't know how long yet, but it sure seems like, you know, we're able to.
Wait a minute, we're not even close.
We didn't break the surface yet.
But the key is this, is that, you know, I always believe, hey, leave them before they leave you, which for me is respect for your audience, that we can share memories, we can share little moments. I think though, perhaps before we leave, we ought to share a moment each just to our kupuna. What would you say to our kupuna, my brother?
Thank you. Mahalo nui loa. I mean, I don't know what else to say. I'm hoping that maybe my opuna will say thank you, Papa, one day. For, you know, for being there. And I know, you know, my memories of my tutu man, Joseph Kauhi, you know, he was a bugler in World War I, and he's up at Punch Bowl. And so I often go walk up there, just walk from, you know, Kakako walk up, spend time with him, tell him thank you. My grandma is at Oahu Cemetery. She passed at a young age, so my mother had to become the, you know, the wahine for the family. My uncle Richard Kauhi is fantastic. You know, he imparted a DNA of music in me that is often, you know, replicated in some, but he was ahead of his time. And then of course I got to thank my Filipino grandpa, my tutu man from Kakaako was a fisherman. You know, my Portuguese grandma, you know, Vina Doyle's every
strong
every Thanksgiving. And but what did they give me? They gave me the ku and the punavai. So they, you know, and whenever I look in the mirror every morning, if the guy is looking back, it's a good day. What about
hey,
you? What about
you? I'm with you. And for me, grandpa was 5'3". He was a tugboat captain to Molokai and back. Captain Sam Kahoʻāno. He and his wife, Mary Kalama Kahoʻāno, had 16 children. 5'3", she was 6 feet tall. She loved him so much, bro. He was in Maluhia Hospital. when he passed away, 2 weeks later, my grandma passed away. And on the other side was David Kamaiopili. So he was from Kauai, actually, and his roots, and his wife was Helen, belonged to the Boyd family, the Cleghorns, all of that heritage. So they brought that other side, Kauai. So Hawaii and Kauai coming together in one family, and we can understand that that is indeed very, very special, and that no matter what we do in the blessings of today,
that there's always new information to share. That Hemahema wasn't just, he was special to both our culture and Christianity. That there are so many people like him who were treated so that they were down and stepped on and said that they were negative. But the truth is, everybody has a light. We all have a light. The guys behind the cameras over here in the office, we all have a light. Yeah. Brother, thank you for making that light brighter. Mm. Thank you.
Good to be here with you.
Had a good day. Yeah, well, thank Ruben, thank Don, and thank everybody over here at Kūpuna Network for inviting us. Hopefully they'll invite us on again and we can share more, you know. But, you know, Kūpuna Power is about you, and it's hopefully, you know, you'll take those special moments and weave them into a good chapter to share with those of you who are coming up and through, like the young camera guys around here, the sound guys around here. They're probably listening to us and go, oh, gee whiz, when are they going to finish this gig?
And one more thing, if I can add.
Yeah.
That Kūpuna is not just about the Hawaiian aspect of Kūpuna. That my closest friend, whose grandpa was Filipino, was a treasure of Kūpuna. Japanese who have come and become a part of the plantation system, so humble, part of the islands. People who came from Europe, Portuguese, as you mentioned before, the heritage. How beautiful, yeah? All of the people of the world coming to Hawaii. Because why? We're lucky that with this COVID-19 and all restrictions we have, that we still have our wonderful Hawaii.
Yeah. So to everybody, mahalo nulu a Kūpuna. And we'll see you there, okay? Until next time, I'm Brickwood Galuteria.
I'm Kimo Kahoʻāno.
Aloha.